Hello, good morning to everyone. Let us see today how to generate pure sinusoidal AC voltage using DC voltage. Nowadays, you can find SPWM microcontrollers in the market, and they are widely used in pure sine wave inverters. SPWM stands for Sinusoidal Pulse Width Modulation. This microcontroller can store the required commands to generate the necessary waveform for the inverter through proper design of switching pulses. The basis is to use an H-bridge to reverse the load current by inverting the DC voltage across the load terminals alternately. When S1 and S4 switches are closed, DC current flows through the load from left to right. When S2 and S3 switches are closed, voltage reverses through the load terminals, and current flows from right to left. The DC voltage is taken here as 325 volts, since the maximum voltage of the RMS AC voltage of 230 volts that we are going to produce is 325 volts. If this switching is done alternately, a square wave is generated, and the maximum and minimum values being plus 325 volts and minus 325 volts. When consider the analog sine wave of the 230 AC voltage, frequency is 50 Hz. Please note that the power supply voltage frequency and the value differs depending on the country you live in, and changes should be made accordingly. Frequency is the number of cycles performed in 1 second. Periodic time is the time taken for one complete cycle to perform. To get the periodic time, divide 1 second by supply frequency of 50 Hz. You get 20 milliseconds as periodic time. Let's consider half of this cycle now. It's divided to 4 switching cycles, and the period of one switching cycle here is 2.5 milliseconds. Let's switch on S1 and S4 switches for half of the first switching cycle, and switch off for next 50% of the cycle. You know, the duty cycle is the percentage of on time of the switching cycle, and the pulse width is the time duration of the duty cycle. You can learn more about duty cycle and pulse width by watching the video at the link above, displayed at the top right of the screen. The second switching cycle also has a duty cycle of 50% and a pulse width of 1.25 milliseconds, but it is on the negative side, because current has reversed through the load, operating switches S2 and S3. Although the frequency of the switching cycle is the same, with the same periodic time of 2.5 milliseconds, the third and fourth switching cycles have different duty cycles and pulse widths. When consider the voltage values generated during the switching cycles, 325 volts has become 162.5 volts in the first cycle, that is 50% of the full value. You will see, the four switching cycles obtain different voltage values, depending on the differences in pulse width, and depending on the operation of the different sets of switches. For these voltage changes to occur, you have to operate these switches extremely fast, and thereby generating very short pulses. So to get these very small pulses, without any short circuit issues, you should use IGBT switches for your H-bridge circuit. IGBT stands for Insulated Gate Bipolar Transistor. Out of the three pins on it, C is the collector, and is to be connected to the positive side of the DC circuit. E is the emitter, and is to be connected to the negative side, or to the ground. G is the gate, and when positive voltage is applied to this gate, it will create a conductive channel between collector and emitter, allowing current to flow through the channel. A commonly used switching frequency for medium power inverters is 20 kHz. Periodic time for 20 kHz switching cycle is 50 microseconds, and is effectively achievable with these type of IGBT switches. Here in this graph, voltage cycle is divided into 12 switching cycles. To get periodic time of switching cycle, divide 20 milliseconds by 12 numbers of switching cycles, and is 1.67 milliseconds. So the frequency of the switching cycle is 600 Hz, after dividing 1 second by 0.00167 seconds. To program the microcontroller, you need the sine values of the associated angles on the voltage sine wave. The maximum value of the sine wave is obtained at 90 degrees, and the value of sine 90 is 1. So at 1, you have to supply maximum voltage, and that's 325 volts. To achieve this value, you need a 100% duty cycle. Let's start with the first switching cycle, and to get the voltage value at this stage, you need the sine wave value of 15 degrees. It's 0.258, and to get the associated voltage value, multiply it by the maximum voltage of 325 volts. So you get 83.8 as the voltage here, and you will understand that to get this voltage value, the duty cycle must be 25.8%. To achieve this voltage value, your microcontroller should close the IGBT switches S1 and S4 for 25.8% of the total time of the switching cycle. The switch on time or the pulse width here is 0.43 milliseconds. Second switching cycle voltage is to be decided using the sine 45 value. It is 0.707, and the related voltage value is 229.7 volts. So the microcontroller should close the S1 and S4 switches for 70.7% of duty cycle, allowing a pulse width of 1.18 milliseconds. Third switching cycle voltage value is related to sine value of 75 degrees, and the value is 0.965. So the voltage value is 313.6, and is very near to the maximum voltage now. Duty cycle is 96.5%, and the S1 and S4 switches are at closed position for 1.61 milliseconds now, out of the total of 1.67 milliseconds. The voltage value of the fourth switching cycle is related to the sine value of 105 degrees, and you will see that it is the same value as sine 75. So you get identical values for switching cycles 3 and 4. Continue this for the next two switching cycles, and you have now completed half of the sine wave. Seventh switching cycle voltage is related to sine value of 195 degrees, and you will see that the value is minus 0.258 here. To achieve this negative voltage value of 83.8, switches S2 and S3 must be closed for 25.8% of the duty cycle. So continue this process with the remaining switching cycles as well, to complete one voltage cycle. All these sine values you can get using internet. Microcontrollers can be programmed using correct sine values and the pulse widths to generate the required smooth sinusoidal waveform, and should be repeated to create the continuous voltage sine wave. You will see that the waveform we have created here is not good enough, because it is divided into only 12 switching cycles. If you divide the sine wave into 24 switching cycles, then the periodic time of one cycle is 0.833 milliseconds, and the switching frequency is 1.2 kHz. This waveform is much better than the previous waveform, but still not close enough to the smooth sine wave generated with analog signals. Typically, an analog signal is a continuous signal, and represents data as a continuous waveform. It can take on any value in a time range, and can have an infinite number of possible values over a period of time, like the values of a sine wave. So, to get an almost perfect smooth curve, that is a pure sine wave, you can divide this sine wave into very small switching cycles, possibly with a periodic time of 50 microseconds. Since IGBT switches are able to handle such small pulses, with a switching frequency of over 20 kHz, the SPWM microcontrollers can be programmed with over 400 switching cycle voltages to generate a pure sine waveform for the inverter. I hope, now you know, how to program an SPWM microcontroller to generate a pure sine wave for an inverter. If this video is useful, please subscribe the channel. Thank you.